Hey guys, today I'm going to do a plan with me for the week of July 24th to 30th. And I'm sorry, I haven't been filming lots of videos lately. It's just been crazy at work. July and August usually are the busier months at my work, and I basically work very, very long hours. So it's hard for me to be able to film for you guys. But yeah, I really, really want to get this video out for you. And I'm sorry if there's not going to be that many plans going on and stuff like that, just because I do have a lot of work, so I don't really have time to really do anything or have anything planned. So yeah, so I'm using a kit from Simply Ginger Co. It's one of our tropical kits, just a few of these. I don't know what the name of this kit is called, but the quote just says, or the little thing just says, tropical vibes. So that might be the name of the kit, I'm not quite sure. So yeah, so it comes with your full boxes, your ombre heart checklists. Here you have your icons, heart checklist, cutout icons, weekend banner, build do, quarter boxes, flags, half boxes, headers, little things, some sidebar items, and then you have your washi. I also put in some glitter headers because I really thought this kit would look perfect with glitter headers because how tropical it looks. So I've got this kind of pink color here, this kind of green color, I think it's this one that I'm using, or this one, either one. This yellowy gold color, and then this orange color right here. This one's from Murdoch Proxy, all this one's from Nicole Hutch Designs, and the rest are from Simply Ginger Co. So without further ado, why don't we just get right into the video. So as usual, I'm going to put down my bottom washi. And if you're wondering, these inserts, I've actually have people ask me before. They're actually in my shop. I do have a printables planner inserts kind of shop. I have mostly personal size ring bound planner, as well as traveler's notebook in A6, B6, and personal size. And I also have this insert here, which is kind of like the Erin Condren vertical, but fit in your happy planner. So definitely get your hands on these if you really, really want it. And I'll have my shop link below. I also have down below is my coupon code, so you can save yourself some money. So the code is YouTubeFam10, and you can save yourself 10% off, no minimum. Definitely check out my Instagram at TheGLOSSette. I don't have a separate Will & Bob Co. Instagram page. Just check out my regular Instagram page, and I'll have more information about my sales and giveaways and different things pertaining to my shop will be on my main Instagram page, which is TheGLOSSette. So definitely go and follow me there if you want to be updated and notified about my shop. But yeah, definitely go and check that out and get your hands on these inserts. I know a lot of people have actually asked me about these inserts, and that is a place you can get it. And all my inserts are like these kinds are all dated, and all my dated inserts are quarterly. You can get them at a bundle for every 6 months if you would like, or every 12 months. I can't seem to plan and talk at the same time because I haven't done this in a while, and I've had a long day of work, and I'm just making dinner right now, and I've just had it simmering. It needs to simmer for a while, so I am filming right now. So that's why I'm all over the place, and I don't like when I'm all over the place because it's harder to edit. I can't just like watch my whole thing and just like edit a few bits. I have to like, you know, do a lot of editing, which I kind of don't want to do because I don't really have time for that either. But anyways, I don't even remember what I was saying, but I was just all over the place. All right, I was talking about my inserts and how the dated ones are in quarterly format, so every 3 months, so January to March, April to June, and so forth. And if you want to get them at a discount, you can get the 6 month bundle or the 12 month bundle of them, and I have them in all sizes, and the one that you see here as well. These ones don't really matter because they're not in booklet format, but any of the traveler notebook ones, when you print them out, they should be printed out quarterly. Even if you buy the bundle, they're meant to be quarterly. I don't quite remember, but definitely for personal size ring bound planner inserts, as well as personal size TN traveler's notebook, there is all the 2017, as well as the some of the 2018 up until June of 2018. Same as these ones. I think these ones go up to June of 2018. So yeah, definitely go and support my shop. That would mean a lot to me. Help me a lot. So yeah. So last time I left you off telling you that I might go camping, and I'm not quite sure because a month before I went camping, we were planning on going and it just didn't work out and everything like that. So I actually did on the Canada Day long weekend, which is Canada Day. If you're not in Canada, it's on Canada Day is July 1st. So that that weekend, which is our long weekend, I actually did go camping, and it was really good. It was the first time going camping where we would need to take a 4x4 vehicle, and it wasn't as hard as it was before. Apparently, the year before, the people we went with, some of them went there and the roads were pretty bad. They have tamed it quite a bit, and if you've not done 4x4, as long as you're pretty good at driving, you will have no problem. So my husband had no problems driving one of our friends' vehicles, and we had people who were very experienced to help in that department, like to guide us through the very hard parts of the road. So that was good, and camping was really nice. And it was kind of sad because we were on the one side, I think the west side of the lake where we're at, and on the east side there was a forest fire. Luckily it didn't spread across to us where we were, but we were able to see the smoke and everything, and then it was pretty bad. And we had some I don't know what they're called, like these wildlife forest fire kind of people that came around to make sure we were okay, and to just like let us know or remind us that, you know, our campfire can't be too high, we can't make some crazy bonfire thing, obviously because of the forest fire that was going on the other side of the lake. And since like a few days after that, after our trip, there was a thing where now you can't have fires, so campfires are banned, which kind of sucks because next month my husband and I were going on a trip, or like yearly trip, and we are going to a few hot springs, which we did last year, but we're only going to this year, and they're all like attached to like campsites and stuff. We like to do that kind of style instead of staying cabins, because cabins were expensive, and yeah, it's just easier to do camping. But it kind of sucks because we aren't able, to have a campfire. So we did end up, I'm using Asterisk, I want to see if she still has those hearts, so I want to mark hubby's work, because I just like to use hearts to mark anything hubby related. Yeah, she still does have the hearts. So we did end up going to a local store. I don't think it's local, I think it's it might be Canada-wide, so I could mention it. It's called Army and Navy. It's supposedly a department store, but it has a section on their one of their floors, a full floor of all camping stuff. So we decided, because we can't use the campfire and we weren't sure when the ban is going to be over and whatnot, and we want to just invest in something, we got like a grill top. So like it's like a one stove burner and the other one's a grill top. So you can actually, we were thinking of getting it because our barbecue is a little too, it is portable, but it's a little too big to bring with us if you have to bring a lot of gear and stuff. So we're gonna buy the two stove burner things anyways, the camping burners that you can use, like the basically the barbecue propane tanks to use with them. And we were gonna get them, but we, because of the ban of the campfire, we couldn't do like chicken wings and different things like that. I'm sorry if you can't see what I'm doing here. So we've decided to get one that has the grill top, like I was saying, and then the other one is just a burner. And on our camping trip on the long weekend there that we just did, someone brought theirs, and you could actually cook regularly, like with a pot or like a frying pan on the the part where you grill. So that's good to know that we could do that, because it's nice to have an extra element if you're gonna do some cooking. I don't think we're gonna do that much cooking, like fancy kind of cooking, because last time we went camping we had someone who was a chef. He's no longer like, doesn't do that like for his like day job anymore, but he was a chef, so he's really good at cooking and stuff like that. So he was doing that for us. So I'm gonna put my shows. Tuesdays is Amazing Race Canada, and Thursdays is where's the orange one here? Is the show Alone? And then Sunday is Game of Thrones, which is just for my hubby. I just like to mark it because this past Sunday was the premiere, the 16th or something. And I just like to mark it for my husband. Plus, I had like a sticker from a freebie from a shop that I just wanted to use because it was a Game of Thrones sticker and I wouldn't be able to use it otherwise. So now I'm just going to put on the glitter headers here. So the other thing I want to talk to you about is I've been thinking a lot about dyeing my hair. I have dyed it on my own before. I haven't done it for about a year and a half, 2 years I would say, because I didn't want to ruin it and stuff for my wedding, and I didn't want to get it professionally done because it's just expensive to get my hair professionally dyed. Plus there's a lot of maintenance and my hair is long, so that will cost me a lot. And I want to do ombre because I want to dye my hair red, like mermaid red, but it's a lot of maintenance and I have black hair, so my hair, I'm pretty sure would grow out and you can see the roots and everything like that. So I don't want any of that to happen. So I want to do ombre, and so it's less damaging, but at the same time it's not really less damaging to my hair because ombre is like the bottom part of your hair, which is like the most damaging part of your hair. So yeah, well, I'm still thinking about that, about next month maybe during my holidays. I have 2 weeks of holidays. My first week of holidays I'm not really doing anything, I'm just staying in town, like a staycation. So I could go and get my hair done if I want to have lots of time, but I'm still thinking about that because it would cost me a lot. And speaking of the damage in my hair, about a month or two ago, I don't quite remember when, but I think it was about a month or two ago, I trimmed off my hair. So my hair was really long, it was like below my boobs. I'm just using that as a like judge of how long it was, and then I cut it, so now it was in the middle, and then now just recently I cut it and now it's, the length is like above my chest, kind of above my boobs, if that makes any sense. So it's the shortest I've had in a long time, but it's like when you look at it, it's still considered long. And I usually have my hair tied up when I go to work and stuff like that, or mostly unless I'm going out and stuff. So I don't really have it down, so people, like, you can see that it's long, but people don't really know the actual length of it. So now that I have it cut, I can tell a difference, and my hubby can tell a difference. Even usually he's not really, how do I explain it, like, guys, they just don't notice things like that. But because it is way shorter than I have done it before, he kind of noticed, but in a good way he noticed, so that's good. But I just, yeah, I still feel like even after I cut it, I still have like so much dead ends. Like, I cut it originally about a month or two ago, like I said, because it was so dry and there's so many split ends. And now that like I've cut it even more, I could still see the split ends, so my hair is quite damaged. And I don't know why, because of course, like I said, I've dyed my hair previously before on my own, so obviously that dries your hair out. And but I don't know why I haven't been using hair straighteners for a while, because now I just tie my hair up on a regular basis, so I don't really use hair straighteners. I don't really do anything special to my hair. I just use like shampoo and conditioner. I use like the moisturizing kind, so I don't know why my hair is just being like super dry. So yeah, that I don't know. But I'm gonna put a couple strips of washi down here. The only thing I do different in my sidebar now is that I don't do the Etsy packages, tracking them, because I used a 3-heart checklist before. I just have way too many packages, and I just track that in my traveler's notebook instead. So I just do an ombre heart checklist there. If I could find the remaining ombre heart checklist here. Actually, no. I'm going to do my weekly ombre. That's what I'm going to do first. So I'm going to do this one. Weekly ombre is just to mark my work. I'm sorry if you hear some stuff in the background. I'm making rice in a rice cooker and stuff, so you might hear a little bit of noise. It's the only time I have to film. I was going to make what I make tonight. I was making curry. I was going to make it last night, but my hubby had some leftover lunch, so he basically ate that, and I just made like a ginormous salad with some chicken flings to make a little meal, because I feel like I've been eating really crappy lately, and I just feel, I don't know. I'm on this, like, trying to lose weight and stuff. Like, if you know me really well, you could probably tell that I've gained weight. If you don't, you're like, whoa, you lose. Like, and when I tell people how much weight I've lost, people look at me like, really? And, like, people who don't know me look at me like I don't need to lose weight. Because I am a very petite person, but I have gained a lot of weight the last year. So I've been doing really, really well, and I've started doing it since the end of February, just right before Lent. I started like a week earlier before Lent. Lent starts Ash Wednesday or Fat Tuesday, which is Mardi Gras. I know most people might know Mardi Gras a little more than you would Lent. So yeah, it was like a week before Mardi Gras was when I started doing this. So yeah, I've been doing really, really well in terms of that, but this week I just, or this past couple weeks, and then when I went camping, it was like not really, really good. I was like eating really poorly. I still don't do sugars and sweets and treats and stuff like cakes and donuts and any of that kind of stuff, candy, I don't do. But I think my weakness, I found out after quitting sugar, is chips or like salty snacks. I'm like very into like very salty snacks, which is kind of like actually probably just as bad for you, and like fried, like, because obviously chips are like fried and they're not really that healthy for you. Anyway, so now I'm done with my sidebar. I'm gonna go ahead and do my day-to-day planning. So now we can do the day-to-day planning, and I'm sorry if there's not a lot of plans and not a lot of things and just some of the mundane stuff going on, because like I said, this week, or just in general this summer, I'm working a lot. And this week, actually, let me just start planning so we don't spend too much time here. But this week, actually, I'm working a split shift. So I work at a daycare, so we operate in the summer, we basically operate anytime between 7 to 6. So basically anytime between 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. of course we need some staff people to work there, because there's gonna be kids there. And I've got scheduled for this week, the week that I'm planning for, to do a split shift. There was one of our supervisors, we got more than one, that's working at the site that I'm working at this summer. And one of them does a split shift all summer, and this is the week that she's off. So I basically got her shift. I don't know who's covering or who's doing my shift or whatever, or the shifts, the kinds of shifts. I've been doing more like midday kinds of shifts. So yeah, I don't know who's doing that. Wait, and then I have a month. This is to mark Coffee Monday. And I've also want to mark, I have a bill due. And I don't really like using the bill due stickers. So I just use one of these labels. Is there, there's no green one, so I'm just going to do this because I like color blocking, generally speaking. I'll do a yellow one here. I need some of those other labels for the other days. And it is my Visa, so I'm going to use a Visa icon. So yeah, I'm working basically like 7 to 11 and then 2:30 to 6. So I'm still working my 7 hours that I do in the summer. But I have to work a split shift. So what that means is, working split shift is I would go to bed early, and then so that I could wake up early to go to work. And then after work, work my laundry here. After my morning work, I'll go home, eat lunch, take a nap, and then go to my afternoon portion of my work. And then come home, eat some dinner, make dinner, eat dinner, whatever, and then have to go to sleep. So basically, I have like, when I do split shift like that in the summer, like I basically can't do anything at all for that week. Like for that week that I'm working that shift, it's basically eat, sleep, work, that's it. So I kind of don't really like it that much. I'm using the Butt First coffee stickers from Let's Plan It. Oh, and if you're watching this video the weekend it is up. I'm gonna do it sideways because it fits better, like angled like that. If you're watching this video the weekend it's up, there's actually a sale called the Great Canadian Planner Sale, and Let's Plan It, I think, is on there as well. A lot of Canadian shops, so if you want to try out some Canadian shops, or if you're just Canadian and you just want to save on shipping and stuff like that, definitely check out the sale. It's on the weekend that this video is up, so if you're watching it, so the weekend before this Monday here, yeah, definitely go check that out. It is called the Great Canadian Planner Sale. I'm just putting a half box here. I'm not gonna film video on this day. Usually I do, but I can't on this day. Like I said, I'm working a split shift. Oh, and I was gonna mark, I have it on my kind of like perpetual calendar, which is in my traveler's notebook here. I wrote Monkey Monday, which is kind of like a $2 Tuesday kind of deal with the shop that I'm PRing for, Planner Monkey Co. But because she's in the planner, Great Canadian Planner Sale, she's obviously not gonna do that. So definitely go and support my girl. Definitely let her know if you order from the Great Canadian Planner Sale from Planner Monkey Co. Let Sydney know that I sent you. That would be amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. So on Tuesday, I also do my full spread. So I have these full spread stickers, hot pink one. These are from Let's Plan It as well. I do have a coupon code for Let's Plan It whenever you want to order. I think it's 15% off. I always have it down below in the description. But she's probably going to have a better discount during the sale. So definitely go and make use of that. Of course, I'm going to put Hump Day because this week just basically has not really that many plans. I was supposed to put some washi there, so hold on. Oh, there is a matching washi, which is good for this day. And then I'm going to put Hump Day. My Hump Day sticker is from, I got a few script stickers from a few shops. I think it's from Van Sticky. Yeah, right here. I love her scripts and also her character stickers. Find them. Oh, I finished using this, but I'm collecting the bows from her sticker shop because you can get free stickers and stuff like that. So I don't want to throw out that sticker even though the sticker sheet's done. Yeah, I'm just gonna put Hump Day right there. That looks cute. That day is laundry, basically. That's it. So gotta put lots of washi here. I hope I'm zoomed in enough for you to see everything. I feel like I am not. But when I fan out my planner, you won't be able to see the whole planner. It's kind of at a weird angle. I'm sorry if it is. And I haven't filmed Plan With Me videos in a really long time, so I'm sort of not getting the hang of this. So I got a flag here to put laundry. Got lots of laundry stickers. I think I'll stick with Van Sticky since I'm doing that anyways. And I've been recently liking this one in particular. I don't know why. I used to thought it was really big, but this week I have nothing going on, so that just looks stinking cute. And I put that in my traveler's notebook spread as well. So basically that's it for that day. I probably will get a few things done. I don't know, I don't have time when I'm working a lot, but like I said, this week is very boring. Thursday usually when I get groceries, but I won't be able to get groceries Thursday. Probably if I have some energy on Friday after work, I can go get groceries because I'm not working Saturday. So yeah, but there is a bill due and it's an orange one. I want to put a half box there so like if anything exciting happens or whatnot, I can mark it down or just my mood or whatever. It's just nice to have it there. And I'm just gonna put here. Luckily this one has matching washi, and I'm just gonna put that my internet and cable bill is due. Try to figure out what to use, whether I'm gonna use the computer one or the TV one. I think I'll use the TV one there because I'm not marking anything TV related because all my TV are in the little things. And it is Hubby's payday. She does give this payday thing. Don't know if I want to use that. Maybe I will just stick to this kit and make things really easy, but my flag I will use. Flag here. It's my payday. Yeah, just seeing if I have used payday. Oh, on this day I do my spread. I do my half week spread. So I'm still gonna use a Let's Plan It one half week. If there's an orange one here, perfect. I like these, how they fit somewhat in these checklists. So I can just check them off as I go instead of having to write it. So I got that down there. On the 28th, there's another collective planner sale. I don't have a color that is matching. So this day I would do that one. This day I could do that one. Yeah, so I'm gonna use a, should I use a pink one? Yeah, I'm just gonna use a pink one. Too bad for color blocking. I'm really, really into color blocking. I like the look of it, but sometimes it's hard. Just gonna do some yellow washi here to fill that in because this day is just a sale. And I usually mark Friday. I think I still could mark Friday. I'll use my Create With Pen sticker to mark Friday. And it's a little girl. And I'll just mark it at the top where it says Friday, if I can find it. Friday. Yeah, it fits right here perfectly. So there is the sale going on. So I don't know what sticker I want to use to mark that. I think I'll use my monkeys. I'm using a lot of my monkeys in this spread. So use my monkey sticker, the Etsy one. Like I said, on the weekend this video is up. If you're watching it, on the weekend this video is up. There is a huge Canadian planner sale, Great Canadian Planner Sale. And Planner Monkey Co. is part of it. If not, you can always use my code GLOSSette 15 for 15% off your order. If you order from that big sale, like the Great Canadian Planner Sale, definitely let Sydney know that I sent you. So this is a Planner Boss collective sale. It's one of the very first collective sales that ever started. You can follow their Instagram and stuff. And lots of shops are being part of it. And there's a few shops that I recently been really liking. And it's just nice to order from when they are part of a huge sale. So I also have laundry this day. So I do laundry Monday, Wednesday, Friday. I don't know if you already caught on to that thing. And let's see what kind of stickers I have for laundry here. I want to use any yellow ones. Oh, these are kind of like greenish yellow. They're more like green though. Yeah, I'll just use it. It's for my Queen Bee designs. They look yellow enough. They're pretty cute, but I'm running out of a lot of colors there. On Saturday, usually I post my main spread, but I don't think I could because, yeah, I'm just going to work too many hours this week. But I'm probably going to go do stuff with my hubby. So I'm just going to do a half box and a quarter box to put it there. So if we could do anything interesting, I can mark it down. Of course, I need some washi. I don't know if there's any pink washi. There is this pink washi. Totally doesn't match this day. This day is like the light pink. But it's okay. It's the flamingos. I just do that. And then Sunday, of course, I gotta mark Sunday. I gotta mark church. There's nothing going on specific on this day, I don't think, at church. So I'm just gonna mark regular church. And I'm gonna do, I think I might put a half box if we do something this day. My church sticker I'm going to use, I think it's from Let's Plan It. One of my favorite church stickers. Too bad she doesn't really sell these anymore. So I guess not that many people use church stickers. Oh, but yeah, I like to mark church like that. Also, I forgot to mark on Sunday, I do my hashtag before the pencil, before I fill out the next week's spread. So even if I don't film it, I still post it on my Instagram. So always follow me on Instagram at create. Always follow me on Instagram at TheGLOSSette. And this is just from Create With Pen. It's the cutest. When I'm not doing full week or half week spread, I like to mark it with these ones. These are super cute. I need to plan it because I tend to use a lot of the pinks. So yeah, that is for that. And then I have my weekend banner I gotta put down here. I'm gonna put on the very bottom because I have a few things I have to. Oh, I forgot to put the half box. How could I forget to put the half box? Okay, since I don't have much going on, I'm gonna put the weekend banner up here like I usually do, because I have two kinds of things I need to mark down there, actually. Put my church one there. So I have some countdowns I gotta put down here, and also Rocky Holidays. I did find my July one, so I went back and did all the weeks I didn't do. So I'm just gonna do that. Actually, I'm gonna do the countdowns first, which is countdown to my hubby's birthday. Yeah, here, which is ironic that my friend who owns Planner Monkey Co, Sydney, her birthday is the day after my husband's birthday. So I kind of, once I found out, I kind of like, just easy to remember and stuff. So yeah, so these are from that planner girl. It's an Australian shop, amazing stuff. And she uses this like vinyl sticker that another Australian shop by the name of Fox and Cactus uses. And they both do like character stickers and stuff, so it's pretty cool. These are just countdowns for today. So I'm just gonna quickly put these down. That's why I didn't want to put the weekend banner down here like I usually do, because usually I only have like either one countdown or just the wacky holiday, but this time I have like two things going on. So I'm gonna put this one is tequila day, and the wacky holidays are from Once More Love. And I can't wait to finish filming this day, this video, because I am super hungry. And I can smell the food is thread and needle day. This is aunt and uncle day. Today is walking on stilts day. My hubby thinks this is the dumbest holiday because like who in the world walks on stilts and you know, goes and do that on that day. And this milk and chocolate day, which is nice. Lipstick day, just fun. Some things are fun, some things are just like, you know, weird. Friendship day, and that's for another week. So that is basically it for my spread. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it's kind of boring. There's not a lot of plans going on. But if you did like it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel to be notified when I post videos. I'll try. But you could always follow me on Instagram at TheGLOSSette. I always have my spreads and all my posts and things like that there, even when I'm not able to film for you guys. So until I see you next time, stay organized.